Hello children, how are you all? Today we are going to start with new chapter, which is chapter number 2, number system. Number system we have already discussed in the last online class, but we are going to start it again so that you can clear your doubts if you have any. So, do you know that computer only understands numbers, and numbers are only two numbers, which is 0 and 1. You have started in the previous class also, then these 0 and 1 is known as binary numbers. So, as a human being, we also speak language, a particular language, to express our thoughts, to share, to give the instructions to somebody. In the same way, we give instructions to computer, but computer does not understand the word or the letters we type in. What happens once we type the words and letters in the computer? The words or letters get converted into numbers, and then only the computer understands what we are trying to say, and then accordingly the computer gives us the output. So we'll start reading with this chapter. We humans speak in a particular language, and this language is made of words and letters. Although we type words and letters in the computer does not understand the words and letters. Rather, those words and letters are translated into numbers. A computer can talk and understand only in numbers, and that is to only two numbers, which are known as the binary numbers. Do you remember? Zeros and ones. Multiple zeros and multiple ones. So that is why we say zeros. We put a S in front of zero and ones. Why computers use binary number system? A computer need to convert the instructions given language to binary number system. So binary number system is used by computers because a computer can understand only two states, that is the presence or the absence of the electrical pulse. You need to underline the next line here. A binary digit is called a bit. So whenever we call about the binary digit 0 or 1, it is known as a bit. There are two possible states in a bit, which is expressed as 0 and 1. So 0 is one bit and 1 is another bit. And these are the two numbers used in the binary number system. A bit could represent on and off of an electrical circuit, yes, no, true, false, zero and non-zero, or similar two states or binary wording. Since computer work on electricity, we can use these two states only. It can be off, it can be off, the answer can be in true or false, zero or non-zero. Okay. Now to represent each number or character, we use only these two states. A series of 8 bits makes a byte. So a series of 8 bits. So bit is the smallest unit of memory in the computer. I hope you all know about the memory chart. You have heard about the KB, MB, GB, TB. Right? A series of the 8 bits makes a single byte, a byte. Now 1024 bytes makes a 1 KB. And 1024 KB makes 1 MB. And 1024 MB makes 1 GB. So remember this. And 1024 GB equals to 1 TB. So that is the memory table you have started in the, maybe in class 5, 6 or maybe, yeah. So this is an ordered sequence of 8 bits that can represent one of 256, which is 2 raised to the power 8 possible values. So a byte of memory can store a decimal number in a range to 0 to 255. So these are good enough to represent all the printable and non-printable characters. Now we'll talk about this ASCII code. The ASCII code is developed to represent all characters including capital and small alphabets, numbers 0 to 9, punctuation marks and any other special characters which are there on the keyboard. Have you seen so many characters are present on the keyboard? So every character on the keyboard or every number on the keyboard, every special character, every letter has a ASCII code. That you will learn once you will come in class 9 or 10. So why octal and hexadecimal numbers? But before we proceed here, I would like to introduce you the number system. If you see on page number 18 at the bottom, can you see this table here? The number system is divided into four. It is four types. The number system is of four types. The first is decimal, next is binary, third is octal, and fourth is hexadecimal. And every number has a base. Like binary has a base 2 because it contains only 0 and 1. So two digits are there only here, which is 0 and 1. So the base is 2. Now if we talk about the decimal base is 10. And the numbers start in this decimal number system starts from 0 till 9, which means the 10 numbers. And if we talk about the octal's base is 8, where 8 symbols used to represent a number, which is 0 to 7. If you count, it is 8. Hexadecimal base is 16, which means 16 symbols used to represent numbers. 1 is 0 to 9. So 0 to 9 makes 10. 10 numbers, and after 10, the next numbers are represented with a letter. So letter A, capital A, represents here number 10. And letter B represents 11. Then C, 12. D, 13. E, 14. And F, 15. Which includes, so if we talk about 0 to 9 and A to F, which is a total of 16 symbols. So 0 to 9 is 10, and then we have next 6 letters which represents a number. So I hope this is clear to you. The number system is of 4 type. We have a different base, and then we'll learn how to do the calculation in the next coming classes. So why octal and hexadecimal number system? So we have seen the octal base is 8 and hexadecimal base is 16. Octal and hexadecimal numbers are a convenient way to represent binary numbers. So these two numbers are a convenient way to represent binary numbers, which is used by computers. So computer mechanics often need to write out binary quantities, but in practice, writing out the binary numbers, such as this long number is written here, 10010011001001, is tedious and prone to errors. You can get errors. Therefore, binary quantities are written in a base 8. So it is very difficult to write these many numbers. You can get errors also. So that is why the binary numbers are written in a base. It can be octal base or a hexadecimal base, base 8 or base 16. So this is why you need to understand the four most common number systems that are frequently used in computers. These number systems are binary, octal, decimal, and hexadecimal, which we have already discussed, remember? So binary base is 2, octal base is 8, decimal base is 10, and the hexadecimal base is 16. Now you can see in this table on page number 17, the number system, the base of these number system, and what these number systems digits represents. So binary represents only 0, 1, octal 0 to 7, decimal 0 to 9, and hexadecimal 0 to 9, A to F. I hope this is clear to you, and I'll be explaining the next topic in the next class. So till then, your homework is to read this chapter very carefully, because it is very important to understand. Okay, that's how the numbers works in the computer system, how the computer understands our instruction and converts it into its computer's understandable language, which is binary language. Okay, so read this chapter, and whatever the doubts you have, join this the oncoming online class, and you can clear your doubts in it. So till then, God bless you everyone.